it's a whole new game now. Project 2020 is now in an entirely different ballpark than it was just a week ago when I made my last video. Had a great response on that video and wanted to get back on as so many things have changed. Over the weekend, cards 87, 86, 85, things were going extremely hot. Some of the old cards, the old short prints were shooting up in price. My collection almost quadrupled in value in just 3 or 4 short days. And then we get to this week at card number 88, the Keith Shore, Ken Griffey Jr. hits a 99,000 print run and things are officially different. So wanted to get on here and just discuss it real quick with you. First of all, want to address a little bit of the panic that has come up that I've noticed on social media and a lot of the groups around Project 2020, people declaring the project dead. I'll say right off the start, I don't think that's the case. While this heavy print run will obviously change things going forward, we've seen some heavy print runs in the past, obviously not to this degree with the Trouts, but we've always seen a dip back down after that initial high print run. So A, I think that may be coming, but B, I think if you've been in this project for a while, like I have, you've got multiples, you have some of the shorter prints, like for instance, this JK5 Ted Williams, anything under 2,000, anything under 3,000, and really now anything under 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 becomes a super short print and something I believe you need to hold on to and not panic sell. And so that's why I'm holding on to cards like this. I'm holding on to cards like the Ben Baller, Frank Thomas. Cards like this, I think, have a long-term value. And personally, I've set a price for myself where if these aren't easily breaking 1,000, I'm going to hang on to them. It's not a short game for me. I'm looking to be in this project for a while. And I think as these print runs continue to grow, if they do, I think there's still value in those. And even when you look at some of the bulk purchases like the Ben Baller, Mike Trout here that everyone probably bought was, I think, the previous highest print run. Those saw a little bit of a dip in price after the Keith Shore 99,000, but I think they'll eventually start to come back up as things settle down. So if you're holding on to, you know, 10 or more of these, I think it's safe to not panic sale, including I also picked up, you guys know, a lot of the Jeters, which in the last video I talked about them only going for like $40, or I think $25. And then by the time I hit the weekend, they were selling for $300 and I had 10 of them. So if you have cards like this, again, I'd hang on. This is the first in the set of Jeter. And I think this is a marathon, guys. We've got 400 cards to go. Not 400 cards to go, sorry. 310 cards to go almost. And things, a lot of things can change. And especially if you have one of these first cards, as we get down the line, I think there's some benefit. My personal strategy, and look, I'll be transparent with you. I've been completely scared shitless about this because what I had was about $10,000 in profits unrealized at the start of the weekend, which quickly bloomed into about $40,000. And to be honest, it panicked me because I don't want to be holding on to $40,000 of cards ever. And I did over the course of a week or two, I have sold off some to basically get to break even to where now I feel very comfortable. And I have actually gone and I'm buying 5 of every card going forward for the near term, at least because financially to me, it's a drop in the bucket. If I happen to hit one, if one of those cards happens to blow up, just looking back at some of the earlier times, I was upset that I passed on certain cards. And so right now, because I can't afford it, I'm just taking that blanket approach. And I will start to sell off every Sunday, I've told myself, because I'm letting the weekends go. Every Sunday, I'll either list some buy it nows or some auctions to expire on the previous Sunday, depending on how I feel the market is settling. And really, I'm only trying to sell off things I have bulk of. You know, for instance, I just got this in today, which is the Matt Taylor Griffey, which I think is a beautiful card. If you haven't got it in hand yet, it just pops way more than it did online for me. But cards like this, I may sell 1 or 2 of just because I have the confidence in that if something happens, I have more than, for instance, the JK5 Ichiro. I had 10 of those. I sold 2 off and I was super happy that those set at the time records for, I think, $430, but then those shot up to $1,000 over the weekend, but it's all good. I have 8 left. So that's one thing I'm doing. And then any short print that I have, you know, for instance, this F dot Mark McGuire, or obviously the Trout, the Ermsey Trout, don't drop that, Ed, come on. You know me, I drop expensive cards. These things I'm hanging on to because I think these are the ones that have real long-term value. And while this is going for 2,000 and change right now, I'm still holding, even though the price I set in my head a while ago was $800. I'm still going to hold on to this for now, because I think when you look at the Ben Baller Ichiro, I know it's the first one in the set and it's a shorter print, but when you look at all the attention the Trout's cards will get, even when some of the bigger guys do their Trout, I think you'll see this one come up in value. Speaking of Trouts, I know I already mentioned it, but this is a card I think was a lower print run than the Ben Baller, and I think we'll have long-term value. But what I'm doing is, especially anything I have under 2,000, I'm just hanging on to it. I've only got one of most of these because I didn't buy these in bulk at the time. But the super, super short prints that I have, I'm going to hang on to for the near being, especially this. This Koufax was a steal on the day that second Trout came out. So that's my approach. I'm still going to continue to buy. I have orders in for five of the next four cards. And I think I'm going to continue to do that. I think you may see a correction in those print runs drop down again. I don't know if we'll ever get into the single digits or the four digits again, but I think there's still an opportunity to catch a lower print run and still make some money back. It may not be the kind of money that I was seeing over the weekend with some of my older cards, but I think there's still some ways that you can get in the game here. Now, if you want to go hunting for some short prints and buy those secondhand, most people that have asked me for advice, I've said, hey, just get in new. I think it might be a bit of a different ball game now. So if you want to get in at this point and you can find some people fire sailing some of those shorter printed cards, again, I would look for anything under 4,000. I think with this new standard, if it continues to raise to the level of almost touching six figures, then I think anything under 4,000 is going to be extremely sought after card. So, you know, maybe the Mattingly from SIF or something. I think that was in the 8,000 range or something. But even then, I think that's trading for under $200, which is a good buy. Another thing you can look at is a lot of these artists are doing autographs. I was able to snag an autograph of Ripken SIF, which is a pretty short printed card. I paid $800 for it, but I think at the price the card was selling at the time was $450. So basically paying a $350 premium for a out of two autograph from him, I thought was a good pickup and a good hold for me. So that's the kind of thing I'm going to be looking to do going forward. But because I've been able to sell some cards and been able to kind of bankroll myself, I can afford to kind of pick up these cards as they come. And if other people drop out, then I'm still in. But if someone's coming in this for the first time, I think, A, I would just buy the cards that you think are cool and do it that way. That's how a lot of us started this, that have made this into a thing. We bought the cards we thought looked cool and we weren't in to flip them right away. And I think you saw that a lot with the Baller Trouts. I think that was one of the first Ben Baller Trouts. That was one of the first cards that kind of brought new people in. And you saw a lot of those people try to flip that card right away. And I think when this card raised to 300 over the weekend and now it's sitting somewhere in the 150 range, which is maybe where it settles, you know, I think a lot of those flippers were a little short-sighted in there. So this isn't, to me, this isn't your traditional flip game, and that's not really what I'm in it for. And I said it in the last video, I expected to hold on these cards for years until they had value, and I'm prepared to do that if I have to, if I don't think I'm going to get the value out of the card. So, you know, that's it, guys. It's just been a crazy ride these last couple days. I know if you're watching this video that you've probably been along for that ride, or you're just now getting wind of it. But I would just have fun with it. Again, I've been super stressed about it because it's a lot of money and it's money I don't want to keep in cards if possible. So I've tried to move a little bit of it to give myself some security. And, you know, I've got a point now that I think I will cash out at eventually, because, you know, we're getting into down payment and on the house kind of territories right now with some of this money. So there's a point where I'll, you know, probably start to try to move things, but it won't be because I think the market's dipping or I'm going to panic sell or anything, because I think there's still, especially if you're one of the ones that have had cards from the beginning, I think there's still opportunity for those cards to grow immensely in value. So hang in there. If you're new, jump on board, just have fun with it. It doesn't have to be a serious flip game thing. If you buy one of those Shore rookie, if you buy one of those Shores printed to 99,000, look, you're probably not going to flip that for any decent profit. Maybe you get your money back on it if you bought it in bulk, but that's okay. Chalk it up to a lesson learned and just have fun with it going forward, and don't try to make the quick buck. And I think with the quality of art these artists are putting out, the way the fan base is responding to those artists, I think you'll be in good shape when we get to the card number 400 and it's all said and done, or even a couple years down the line. If you like this video, please like, comment, subscribe. I really appreciate it. I know a lot of people have been asking me to put out more Project 2020 content, and so I'm trying to oblige that. We'll be coming up on card 100, so I'll have another one of my top 10 countdowns in terms of the art style of the card, how I rank them 1 to 10, numbers 51 through 100. If you didn't check out my first 50, go check it out. I had a really good time doing that. And starting to try to put that list together for this second 50 has been so hard. Would love some of your opinions in terms of visually your favorite cards down below as well. Thank you so much for joining me. Ed Cahill, Cahill Cards. We'll see you soon. Easter egg, if you stayed. The empty boxes are selling for $30. What the fuck?